Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 66 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we will focus our attention on testing in Go. In recent times, a lot of emphasis has been paid to TDD or test-driven development. To support this, Go comes with all the tools and library necessary to write tests out of the box. So let's dive deep into it. Go provides support for testing with testing package and the Go test command. Each test file usually lives in the same package as the function you are testing with the file name that ends with underscore test.go. Please note that the test files are not compiled in the build binary when you run Go build. For example, if you have a function called sum residing in a file sum.go, the test file which will live in the same package will be called sum underscore test.go. By convention, the name of the test function will start with test where x replaces the name of the function you are testing. So in case if we were testing a function named sum, the test function name would be test sum. Let's talk a little bit about the test function. The test function only accepts one argument of type, which is a pointer to testing.t. T here is a structure that helps orchestrate your tests. There are multiple methods available on T that help you do that. For example, T has methods like error, errorf, fatal, fatalf, log, etc. that can be used to print log or results of your test. So whenever we test something, we can use errorf, error, fatal, fatalf, etc. to make assertions or indicate that our test passed or failed. So what's the difference between the error and the fatal methods? The t.error and the t.errorf method fail the test, but the execution continues. This is used, for example, when you want to test fields on a struct and don't want to stop the execution if some of the fields don't match and you are failing the test. So in cases where the next assertion don't depend on the previous assertion, so you still want to continue testing the rest of the assertions. The t.fatal and the t.fatalf methods fail the test and stop the execution. So these should be used when you know that if the current condition for testing fails, all next one will fail as well. So if your current assertion is failing, all the next ones will fail as well. In that case, you would use fatal and fatalf to indicate the test is failing. The struct t has a method called run that is used to run subtests within the test function, which indeed allows for more granular testing. T also provides methods such as cleanup that are used to perform any kind of cleanup if required. The cleanup method takes a closure that can be used to perform cleanups. It is run when the tests are complete. With that basic knowledge, let us move to writing some tests. Here, first we are going to initialize our package. So I'm going to use the gomod command to do that. First, let us create a package called math. Inside it, we will have math.go file. Package math. Here, I'm going to define two functions to find the min and the maximum between two integer values. So the minInt function takes two arguments, which is a and b of type int, and returns the minimum between the two. So we can say if a less than b, return a, otherwise return b. Let me close the terminal. Now I will define another function called maxInt, which is similar to minInt but will return the maxInt. Inside it, we will do a similar thing. If a greater than b, return a, otherwise return b. Let's save it. Now to test it, in the same package, I can create a file called math underscore test.go. This indicates to Go that this is a test file. Now there are two kinds of testing that we can perform. First is a white box testing. In that case, we will define the package or the test package in the same package namespace, that is package math. This means we can test both our exported and unexported methods or fields. And then there is another one which is called black box testing. In this case, we can define the package math underscore test. Go will allow us to do that, indicating this is a test package. All the files inside that directory need to have the same package name. But in this case, since it's a test package, we are allowed to do so. I'm using black box testing in this case because all the functions that we are testing in math are exported. Let's first write function to test the minInt function. As you can see, the function is named test, then followed by the function we are testing. each test function need to have the first argument t, which is from the testing package. Now let's test the minint function. So we can say result of calling minint, which need to be imported from the math package. So we can say math and then minint. Now we supply two values, 10 and 5. So we expect the result to be 5. So we can make an assertion here. If result not is equal to 5, we say t.error. I'm going to use errorf because I want to print the expected and the value received. So I can say expected but got. So here I'm saying expected, which is 5, but got result. So this is a basic test that we have written. Let's now save our file and run the test with the go test command. So I can say go test and then supply this pattern, which means recursively go through all the packages or all the directory in our code and look for underscore test files to test it. Once we run it, we can see it found a test file in math package and the tests are passing. What happens if I change it? Instead of returning minint or the minimum between the two values, now our minint function is returning the maximum. So we expect our test to fail. Let's run the goTest command again to see the output. And as you can see, the tests are failing. We are getting expected 5 but got 10. Let's fix that by reverting back, saving. To verify, let's run our test again. So our test is working as expected. Let me close this. Now let us write a test for the maxin function. Again, we accept testing.t and do the similar thing. Math.maxint 100 and say if result is not is equal to 100, we will fail our test. Expected 100, but we got the result. Let's save it and run our program. Now let us test it again. Go test. And as you can see, both the tests are passing. If instead, for example, I can say -2, which means our test will always fail. And now if I run the command, you can see it will tell you that test maxint is failing because it's expecting 100, got 100, because we did change the expected value, but we didn't make a change here, but the test is failing. So that's basically how you will test a function or method in Go. Now let's move on to table testing. In this case here, we are only testing once with a given input. What if we want to test multiple different cases? You could do that by duplicating this code again and updating the values to different values. But if you do that, you will have a lot of lines below in the test case, which would be harder to read. As such, Go provides you a way to write table tests. Let's remove this and convert it into a table test. So we will create a slice of anonymous structs, test cases, anonymous struct, and which will have name, which is of type string, a, which is an int value that we will use to provide to the function we are testing, b, which is the other int value, and we can say expected, which is again an int. With that done, we can now iterate over test cases and run each individual test with the values from each test case. So we can say for tc rain test cases. Now we can use the run method on the t struct to run the subtest. T.run first is the name of the test you're running. So we can say tc.name and then a closure, which also has t as the first argument. So we can use that to make assertions. Inside it, we will say result math.minint, then tc.a, tc.b. Now let's make assertion. If result is not is equal to what we expect, that is tc.expected, we want the test to fail. t.errorf expected and got, where expected is tc.expected and got is the result we get. Now let's fill our test cases. The first case I want to write is 100 is less than 1000. A 100, B 1000, we expect the result to be 100. Similarly, I can copy this and write another test. -2 is less than -1. So we can say -2 and -1. And the expected value should be -2. Similarly, you can add more test cases in here. So just to recap, we define test cases, which is a slice of struct or anonymous struct in which we provide the data for testing. Then we run through test cases running t.run for each and then making the assertion. Now let's save it and run our tests again. Go test, and you can see it's failing because we didn't fix this one. So we should say result is not equal to 100, only then fail our test. Run our command again. And as you can see, all the tests are passing as we expected. What if I fail one of the tests here? I can change it, the expected value to 0. In this case, if I do go test, you can see it's telling us that a test with this name is failing and providing the line number where the assertion is failing, which is this in our case. Now let's fix it and run our test again. And as you can see, tests are passing. So that's basically how you would write tests in Go, where one form is table testing, which is written like this, and then the other form is regular testing. Now let's move our focus to the test main function. The test main function in Go is a special function used for custom test setup and teardown within a test package. It runs once before all tests are run. When you run tests for the package using GoTest, if the test main function is present in the package, it becomes the entry point for running the test. You may ask, why is test main required? Test main is very useful for shared setup and teardown. If multiple test functions in a package require the same setup or teardown logic, centralizing it in test main can improve the code organization and avoid repetition. You can perform any necessary setup tasks before all tests in the package run. This might involve initializing external resources like the databases, creating temporary directory, or configuring logging. After all the tests are finished, test main can be used for cleanup action, such as closing database connections or removing temporary file. Now the test main function receives a pointer to testing.m that provides method to access and run tests within the package. So to run all tests in the package, you will need to call run method defined on m, which returns a status code, which should then be used to call os.exit. Another thing to notice is that if you want to use some test data files like the text files, SQL files, etc. for your testing, you can create a test data directory in the testing package, and anything inside it will be ignored by the Go compiler. As you saw in our example, we used underscore test package name suffix to make sure that we were conducting black box testing. If you don't want to use black box testing, you can remove the underscore test from the package name. But black box testing is very useful when you want to test the public API or exported functions only from your package. Let's look at some more examples of testing. So as I told you, T can be used for cleanup as well. So you can register your cleanup functions here by calling t.cleanup, which takes a closure, and you can do any cleanup required here. Now let's create a function test main. The first argument is testing.m. So this test main function will run before every test that we run. So this is the first thing to be executed, and all the tests or subtests will be followed by that. Please note that to execute all the tests, you need to call the run method on m. So I can say exit code m.run, and then pass it to os.exit exit code. And that will mean that test main will run all the tests defined in our test package. This is very useful. So if I create a packet level variable here, say something which is of type string, I can use it to initialize it here in the test main and say something is equal to test. Now something can be accessed in all our sub cases. So I can say t.log and something. Now if we run the test, you should see something printed. Go test. You need to have a failing assertion for it to print something. So we can do. So as you can see, when our test fails, we are getting a log statement from line 46 where testing has been initialized to test. Similarly, you can initialize a database connection here and use that throughout your testing, and after which you can just clean up and close the database connection. So let's now summarize everything we have learned in this lesson. We saw that Go provides all the tools required for writing tests through the standard lib testing package and go test command. I will provide you a link to the testing package that you can go through to get a deeper understanding of how tests work in Go. In the future lesson, including the project we will do, we will write tests for every function or method that is testable. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask by commenting under the video or reaching to the Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!